lots of questioners want to know whether you share Congressman Ron Paul's skepticism of the Fed. And I'm going to quote you. This isn't in Basic Economics, but a recent column. Quote, for most of the history of this country, there was no Federal Reserve System. There you go, that dirty trick of bringing in history.
Ah, yes.
There was no Federal Reserve System, which was established in 1914 to prevent bank failures. But bank failures in the 1930s exceeded anything ever seen before the Fed was established. Close quote. If you could, if we could make you dictator, would you abolish the Fed?
Yes.
You would?
Yes. I mean, for the reasons I just gave, the history. There's no, you know, the Fed represented wonderful hopes, but we've had so many programs that represented wonderful hopes that ended in disaster. I don't doubt that someone who is sufficiently scholarly could come up with examples of where the Federal Reserve made things better. But the question is, overall, what was it supposed to do? It was supposed to do not only prevent bank failures. It was supposed to prevent huge changes in the money supply, in particular, great deflations.
Right.
The greatest deflation in American history occurred under the Federal Reserve System. You know, there was a crisis in 1907. J.P. Morgan, the original J.P. Morgan, called the other bankers into a room, supposedly locked the doors, and said, we've got to do something or we're going to all collapse. And they did something, and they didn't all collapse. But the progressives were shocked that one man could come in and take command of the situation, and especially someone who wasn't even in the government.
Right. So what would you do? You'd move us back to the gold standard? Or you'd let banks issue their own currencies the way they did up through the Civil War, say?
They weren't doing any of those things as the time the Federal Reserve was created. We were on the gold standard, though. But whether we're on or off the gold standard, that's another whole set of arguments. There's no evidence that I can see that over this vast period of time that the Federal Reserve has existed, that things on the whole have been better. The great post-World War II inflation was fed by the Federal Reserve doing exactly what they're planning to do now, namely buying up the bonds issued by the Treasury.
Oh, but don't you have, I have to say, I wasn't expecting your answer to run in this direction, so I don't have questions, follow-up questions prepared, or I may actually have to think here in real time. But don't we have the example of that period from 83 through couple of years ago, that 25 years of economic expansion? We had only two downturns. They were both very shallow and very brief. And what you had was Paul Volcker, whom Carter appointed, but Reagan gave the freedom actually to wring inflation out of the currency. He did that by the mid-80s. The economy takes off. Alan Greenspan does a reasonably good job. And then at the end, there's too much money but maybe 5 years of getting it wrong.
So Volcker did was undo the harm that previous Federal Reserves had done.
Including Arthur Burns.
Yeah, unfortunately, who was my teacher and one of my much admired.
Right. Right. So, but what would you replace it with? How would the currency? How would the currency run?
We would replace it. We could replace it with what existed when it was created,
which was the gold standard.
Well, maybe the gold standard, but maybe not. But there's no evidence that what would you replace it? Things always bother me.
They do?
When someone removes the cancer, what do you replace it with?